ओके, सो वेलकमिंग यू ऑल इन द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ टूडेज लेक्चर्स लेक्चर. इन प्रीवियस पार्ट वी वेयर डिस्कसिंग दैट वाई इट इज स्फेरिकल. सो लिसन स्टूडेंट्स, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इक्वल्स टू 1/4πε₀Q/r². दीज ऑल क्वान्टिटीज आर वॉट? कॉन्स्टेंट ओनली. सो ई इज इन्वर्सली प्रपोर्शनल टू आर स्क्वायर. दैट मीन्स इट डिपेंड्स ऑन इनवर्स स्क्वायर लॉ. And whatever quantity which depends on inverse square law, we conclude that quantities are making spherical surface. Okay. So Q is here, R is here. Okay. Because of Q, this is the electric field till a distance R. Okay. So this electric field is making one boundary. Inside this only we will consider the Gaussian surface. So that surface area equals to 4πr². Okay. Now in this equation, in this diagram, we have seen theta equals to 0°. So for a small surface ds, what will be the electric flux? D phi equals to E ds cos theta. Putting the value of E, we will get 1/4πε₀Q/r² ds cos theta. Now, in place of theta, when we will put 0, it becomes 1, cos 0 is 1. So, when we have to find out the flux for the total surface, okay, total flux for the surface. So, phi equals to circle integration of d phi. So, here, when we put the value of d phi, cos theta becomes 1. So 1/4πε₀Q/r² ds. These quantities are constant, so it will come out circle integration of ds. Okay, and circle integration of ds means the whole area, and as we have seen earlier, what is the value of whole area? 4πr². When we will put the value, we get phi equals to Q/4πε₀r² into 4πr². 4πr², 4πr² cancel. Phi equals to Q/ε₀. Okay, or it can be written in other form, which is the standard form of Gauss's law. Circle integration E into ds equals to Q/ε₀. So this law is proved here. Now let's talk about some of its properties. So first property here is that Gauss's theorem is only for closed surface. Second, all the charges reside in the surface considered. That means, like in this case, we have taken only one charge. If suppose another charge is here, one more charge is here, so we consider all that charges together. So suppose inside this, if three charges are there, one is this one will be here, one will be here. So in place of Q, we will put 3Q. Okay, so like that, all the charges reside in the surface considered. Third, charges outside make the flux, but net flux is only due to charges inside. So we can say in simple word that charges outside the surface area can be neglected. Okay, there will be no effect in the flux because of that outside charges. Then fourth, the theorem is used for symmetrical surface to calculate E. That fourth point is the application of Gauss's law, that it is used for symmetrical surfaces to calculate E, electric field intensity. And the fifth one is that Gauss's theorem depends on inverse square law, which we have already discussed. So this is it for today's lecture. See you in next lecture. Till then, goodbye, take care and do some productive work.